For carbohydrates, the respiratory quotient is equivalent to 1. In case of fats, when the fats are used, the respiratory, like respiratory substances in respiration, the respiratory quotient is less than 1. How means? The example is tripomethine. Tripomethine is one type of fatty acid. So when it is involved in the respiration, that gives the energy. And here in the equation, given the volume of CO2 evolved and volume of O2 consumed. Here 251 H98 O6, that represented as tripomethine, 145 O2 molecules are required for 2 tripomethine molecules oxidation, that resulted to 102 carbon dioxide molecule release as well as 98 molecules of water and energy also produced. You see here, according to the respiratory quotient equation, the RQ is equivalent to volume of CO2 evolved by volume of O2 consumed. How much of CO2 evolved according to equation? 102 CO2 molecules are evolved. And how much of oxygen is consumed? 145 O2 molecules are consumed. That is equivalent to, the ratio is equivalent to 0.7. It means when you compare with the carbohydrates, the O2 consumption is more in for fats oxidation, that resulted to respiratory quotient value decreased. It means below 1, that is equal to 0.7. So 0.7 respiratory quotient shown the respiratory substrate as lipids or fats. And come to the proteins. For proteins, the respiratory quotient is equivalent to 0.8 or 0.9. Here also, the required oxygen is more compared to the evolved carbon dioxide. And when you come to the organic acids, they have respiratory quotient as more than 1, 1.4, more than 1, they have the respiratory quotient. It means here the evolved CO2 is more compared to the consumed oxygen. Hence, finally, the respiratory quotient explains the type of respiratory substances as well as how much of O2 is consumed during the respiration and how much of CO2 is evolved.